नमस्ते, दिस इज़ ज्योति कुमावत फ्रॉम द फैकल्टी ऑफ एजुकेशन एंड मेथोडोलॉजी। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू द लेक्चर डिलीवर ऑन द टॉपिक लेसन प्लानिंग फ्रॉम द प्रोग्राम बीएससी बीएड एंड बीएड। दिस बिलोंग फ्रॉम द सब्जेक्ट पेडागॉजी ऑफ बायोलॉजिकल साइंस। सो फर्स्ट वी स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द लेसन प्लानिंग। What is lesson plan? Different teaching methods are available for teaching science, and all these methods are discussed in an earlier units. Similarly, various teaching aids are available for transcribing the curriculum before going to the classroom. The teacher has to select the appropriate method for teaching the topic, and also the proper teaching and which will help the learner to understand the concept in the topic. This is sometimes called planning the strategy. The lesson plan stimulates the teacher to think in an organized manner. It helps the teacher to outline the objective properly. This lesson plan helps in creating the interest of pupil toward the lesson, and a proper correlation is established between the new and old lessons. The lesson plan provides guidance to the teacher as to what and how he should teach. This compels the teacher to think about using teaching aids. This also helps the teacher to choose the best teaching method. The lesson plan inspires the teacher to ask proper and important questions. This lesson also helps the teacher to teach, keeping in the mind the individual differences, and the subject matter is organized in a time frame and with proper sequence. This develops self-confidence in the teacher, and this helps the teacher in evaluating his teaching. Now, the different writer author have suggested some definition about the lesson plan. These are as follows. You can see Bossing define a lesson plan is an organized statement of general and specific goals together with the specific means by which these goals are to be attained by the learner under the guidance of the teacher on a given day. In other words, we can say, as a Lester B. Stand, he said that a lesson plan is actually a plan of action. It includes the working philosophy, his knowledge of philosophy, his knowledge about strengths, objectives, materials to be taught, and his ability to utilize effective methods. Now we talk about the components. There are some components. Basically, these are as preparation of introduction. Second component is presentation. Third as comparison or association. Fourth, generalization. Fifth, application. Then recapitulation. Now come to the first point, preparation or introduction. According to J.F. Herbert, the mind of the students must be prepared to receive new knowledge. It is first like preparing the land before sowing the seed. You can take this type of example. Now, second, this step should be brief and nothing new to be told to the students. The teacher should ascertain what the students know already related to the topic, and should provide a link between the previous knowledge and the new session. This step may involve further steps. Actually, teacher asks some question and he inquired the students what knowledge he actually gained from the earlier study, and then correlate with the further knowledge. Second, thus testing the previous knowledge of students, assuring curiosity by the novelty of experiment or activity, use of charts, pictures and models, skillful discussion, दिस इज़ मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट स्टेप बिकॉज वेल बिगन इज़ हाफ डन. यस. नाउ प्रेजेंटेशन. इमीडिएटली आफ्टर द प्रिपरेशन द एम ऑफ लेसन शुड क्लियरली बी स्टेटेड. दिस बिकम द सेकेंड स्टेप. इन द सेकेंड स्टेप द एक्चुअल लेसन बिगिन्स. स्टूडेंट्स गेट न्यू आइडियाज एंड नॉलेज. द टीचर प्रेजेंट द सब्जेक्ट मैटर टू द स्टूडेंट्स. द स्टूडेंट्स पैसिवली लिसन द लर्नर लर्न द आइडियाज टोल्ड बाय द टीचर एंड द टीचर मे डेमोस्ट्रेट एनी एक्सपेरिमेंट यूज एनी एड और डू एनी एक्टिविटीज. नेक्स्ट कम टू द कंपेरिजन और एसोसिएशन स्टेप. The new ideas or knowledge learned should be compared and association with already known ideas and facts. It is felt that knowledge is not like peeling of bricks, but it is like a tree that grows. This step is most important when the teacher is establishing principles or generalization definitions. Next come to the generalization step. In most of the science lessons, teacher have to arrive at certain generalizations. Formulas, principles, or laws are to be established. As far as possible, the students should draw out the conclusion themselves. Sometimes the student's generalization may be incomplete or irrelevant. At this time, the teacher should guide them to make co-corrections. Next step, come to the application. A lesson of science will be incomplete if the rules of formulas are not applied to new life situations. It is always the desire of the students to make use of generalization and to vary whether they really work in new situations. Knowledge becomes clear and meaningful in this stage sketch. Now recapitulation. This is the last step in the process. Here the teacher ascertains whether the students have understood and grasped the subject matter or not. It is generally done by of the following given steps. As asking suitable questions on the topic taught, applying a short objective type test, otherwise asking the students to label the unlabeled. Now, it should be remembered that these forms of Herbertian steps are not final. These are tentative guidelines actually. We should not always try to rigidly follow them. Moreover, it is not possible to follow all these steps in all types of lessons. In the modern days, these Herbertian steps are included in four steps which are as follows. Preparation, development, review and assignment. These are also we should follow. In this you know very well about preparation. The second step, development, involve the activities of both teacher and students. We can take as a development activity. Teacher have the students to learn the lesson. Both the student and teacher participate in the development. The teacher is expected to develop the lesson with the students' participation. The third step, review, is equivalent to recitation. The fourth step, assignment, is the homework to be given to the students. These are the four steps involved in the lesson plan. We can follow these steps for design a lesson perfectly. Now, next, the topic come in the lesson plan. What are the advantages basically of lesson planning? There are some given advantages. Lesson plan is actually a plan of action. A teacher without lesson plan and is have effort take keep proper discipline in the class and discourage with his failures. A teacher with good plan is also tried, but his triedness is tempered with the joy of satisfaction. The advantage of lesson plan can be as follows. First, it makes the teacher's work regular, well organized and systematic. Yes. It promotes confidence and self-reliance in the teacher. इट हेल्प द टीचर टू प्रोसीड विद पर्टिकुलर एम इन व्यू एंड दस मेक हिम कॉन्शियस ऑफ इंटरेस्ट एंड एटीट्यूड टू बी डेवलप्ड इन द स्टूडेंट्स. नेक्स्ट एडवांटेज इज इट रिटेंडर्स ए सेविंग इन टाइम फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स हैव ए बेटर अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ द सब्जेक्ट एंड डेवलप सम डिजायरेबल एटीट्यूड इन ए स्पेसिफिक टाइम. While in the absence of plan, it might have taken more time for the similar understanding. Next, lesson plan establish proper connection between different lessons of study. Therefore, they provide continuity in the teaching process. It also stimulates the teacher to introduce striking questions and illustrations. It provides greater freedom in teaching for a teacher who has properly planned his lesson, enters the classroom with confidence, without any anxiety, ready to attack the problem and preparation to carry it out like a skilled workman. It also helps the teacher to plan the teaching aid to be used in the class well in advance and also ensure their workability. It avoid wastage of time also. So these are all about the lesson plan and the advantages. I hope you understood all. Thank you.